Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody. Mana here for a fantastic part two of Mission 5. That's right. We are here. The air scandal is real. It's happening right now. We've got the airmail set up. We're just making a ton of money. We do still have to get our final landing permission, and that is out of Los Angeles. And delivering machines, well, that's still trucking along, too. Now, one note as I remove the hated red numbers... that you want to make note of is when the Hoover Dam is complete, it will no longer demand any construction materials. What I quickly did right when that filled up was added a bus stop. That's right, a bus stop, because I'm crazy like that. And we're going to add a few more bus stops because we are going to start flying out of Vegas here. And we want to give them some passenger lines here. Out and about for regular passengers as well. But the whole point was I moved this bus station right here. And I have the freight trucks coming here. And yes, they're freight trucks, but they are dropping off these construction materials now for this industrial market. Which you'll actually see the supply rating going up. I think this is the first guy dropping off the first bit of materials in town. So I brought you right back to it, right when things got interesting. So that's right, part two. Here we go. We got to buy some road vehicles. Let's get some more Schneiders going here. Let's just get two of them. Set line, brand new line. You're going to go from there to there. That's not how you set a new line. Set a new line from there to there to there. And should we have a return stop? No. That's fine. I was thinking about putting a stop on the other side and having them stop on the way back as well. Probably should do it, but we're not going to because we always do that. There's no need to always do things. So anyway, Vegas, it's going all right. We're going to go double speed because we're going to need to. Money's on the way up. That's not going to end the mission, though, so that's okay because we still have way more medals to earn. 12 terminals. I heard it was broken. I don't think it is anymore. We're going to be trying to get it. The only reason I don't have 12 terminals at the moment is three of them that I have built are sitting here in Los Angeles, which we still got to deliver some more before we can really do anything with that. SD machines, though, I do want to get a few more trucks, a truck in here, and I also want to do a little bit with this road. These guys are really struggling with day-to-day traffic. And I'm hoping, let's see if this brings that line. Yes. So it took a little while to load, but the machine line is now running on that route. So passenger travel, just regular commuter traffic can go this way, and then our trucks can turn off and go that way. So we may be able to not make that like a permanent deal, but at least for now, that's going to help deliver a lot more machines, and that's the name of the game right now, delivering the machines. So steel trucking is doing okay. Remember, that's kind of the silly one where it's just delivering the steel from like there to here. Nothing fancy. Now, however, is this encapturing all of the industry? It is not anymore. See, this whole area over here could also use a stop. So we could throw one down. A little stop here. Now, I am curious, how would the goods split up now? If I go steel trucking, and I say, okay, you're going to drop off there. Oh, I know why this got weird. Here's what I want you to do. No, you can go ahead and keep dropping off on three. I am going to add a new line. Three more. And these guys are all going to go from the new line from Los Angeles East to this new stop. Because I don't mind these guys actually. I still don't know why they're bringing some machines over here. And I need more of them just concentrating on steel. Steel like crazy. Like nobody's business. And anyway, on that note, let's buy a few more. Boom, boom, boom. the magic number 3, and we're going to set these to trucking.
To make matters worse, the Postal Authority has also discovered the heavy sacks full of our junk mail. Uh-oh. They have imposed a heavy fine upon us that we'll need to pay off first of all. As we're not currently liquid enough to pay the entire penalty in one go, we've been granted a grace period on part of it. How nice of them, the bandits. Kleptomaniacs.
We need 14 million.
Three quarters of our assets have already been confiscated as a down payment. The rest of this record fine is due when we are liquid enough to pay. It was a success. The former airmail pilot Charles Lindbergh has crossed the Atlantic nonstop. What a triumph! And the development of new aircraft models is rapidly advancing.
Nice.
This progress is opening up interesting areas of business for us. The Douglas Aircraft Company is making its latest model, the DC-3, available to us at a preferential price. Soon, transporting passengers by airplane will be more lucrative than a few bags of mail ever was.
Nice, it's just so expensive. It's almost $1 million per one. And we gotta deliver 300 people? Hold on real quick, what I didn't catch. Oh, we'll catch it when we get just a few more people there. As in... How's this bus doing? Okay. Once we get the landing permission and machines in LA, we will buy a few more DC-3s at that time. But for now, I want to make sure that people are being transported to all the airports. I think the only airport I was having problems with that was Vegas, which seems to all be worked out. Now, what I'm curious about is we just bought that first DC, right? Where's our DC? Come on now. There he is. He doesn't have anybody on him yet. I do want to keep an eye on his first takeoff. Let's enjoy the airmail here. Oh, he hesitated a few times, but he got on up. Landing gear almost fully put away. And I really can't tell you where I remember. I think I sent this guy out to, Las Vegas. So that'll be a nice path across the entire region here. Good, the audio doesn't change when you change the speeds. I thought it would sound like a chipmunk engine. Well, let me repeat that. When I change game speeds, but when the actual airplane changes speeds, as it just showed by example, it will change the engine noise. Look at that, flying over our train line. We are going full speed there. Look at that, major stuff waiting in our coal and iron. That train is just making big money. That's good times. I could have probably doubled that one up too. But look at this, money's coming in really nice right now. So we get more machines going, we get this train a-pumping. Wow. This guy is just slacking on, what's his max speed here? Top speed of 80 kilometers per hour. This is probably the hardest incline of the trip. At least it's while it's empty. That was my thinking, right? It was like when he's coming in full load. Just imagine that, the fear. It's like brakes, please wait. Please work, please work, please work, or you're gonna be in the ocean. That's right, it's the Pacific for you, my friend. Ruby Express. Be on your way. All right, last permissions here. This should be some metal times. Let's go full speed and earn some medals, shall we? Four more deliveries. Drop them off. Do it. Two more. Do it. Mr. America, what do you got for us? Come on now. Come on now. No, probably. Just medals. You got nothing to say. Nothing to say. Anyway, that puts us a little bit closer. Now we just got to finish the mission. So we've got a little over 10 years to get 300 people to fly in these DC-3s. So it's going to be about efficient public transportation. It's going to be about buying way more planes, which buy aircraft. One, set this guy to new line. You get to go from LA to Vegas. Boom. And then buy, you get to go from LA to Phoenix. How cool is that, my friend? That's right, get your delivering on. So we've got more DC-3s on the way. What I'm hoping is LA is going to be pumping as far as people go. Let's hit the air here. Look at all these weird little icons that are missing. I must verify my files. That's what happened last time I saw that. But what I'd like to see is Line 5 is going to need a plane. Line 2 is going to need another plane. And I'm going to go DCs on those. Right, just so we can have a DC on each line. So upgrade, don't upgrade. Buy aircraft. DC, set line. And I'm actually going to go broke so they give me some money, if that makes any sense. We're going to buy another one. And this guy's going to go line 5. Okay. And by going broke, I mean, I want to do it in LA, though. If we're going to go broke, we're going to go broke in Hollywood. Douglas DC-3, there we go.
We're spending money like there's no tomorrow.
Give me $4 million.
Just this once, our financial backers.
They won't give me any more. I can promise you that.
Help us out once again. But this is definitely the last time.
Uh-oh. Which line is... Oh, that's what I get for not naming things. Line 9 is... Which guy goes to Vegas? Vegas. So this is... L.A. to L.V. And you're going to be... blue. We don't have a blue line in the air. Alright. So that's what you get. That's what you get to do. You get to go to LALV. I want to get one of these big guys on each line. These guys, though. I need 20 planes, though, so I'm going to let this happen. That's a lot of planes for a Santa Barbara to Phoenix. We're going to buy him one more. Oh, should we? Should we? Because we... Okay, here's the thing now. Can we deliver 300 people with the amount of DCs that we have now? Because we also need a lot of money. So I don't know if I want to go... Let's see. What do we got now anyway? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I need 7 more planes. I don't really think I want to buy 7 DC-3s. Because look at the difference in price. So I'm going to buy 2 Junkers. Throw these on the LALV line. Buy 2 more Junkers, throw this on the line 10, because I think I know where that is. I think that's the Phoenix line. And let's see how that goes. Okay, that's on the one line I don't know, so right now I guess what we could do is find some planes, name some lines. How about that? Sounds awesome. Line 2. You are San Diego, because I'm cheating by using the stations here. So I know this is SD to SB. Boom. Named, done, gravy. Line 5, you need a name. Remember messing with you. You are San Diego. See, isn't this awesome? Naming stuff. You go to Phoenix, man. You go to Phoenix. Anyway, the missions are going well. I'm excited. We've only got like 2 more missions left. Things are going... very well. Look at this. It's just the airways are filled with planes. Line 10. Can't hide from me, my flying friend. You are LA to Phoenix. LA to Phoenix. Take of that. Oh, red numbers. I saw them. They can't. They find a way to sneak in somehow. There's beautiful LA in the distance. The Hollywood sign in the hills. Just kidding, but. Should be there. Irvine off to the south. Party boat about to disappear into the distance. They're probably the corrupt people. If I would have had that money, we could almost be done right now. But no, we've got to transport way more people. And that's going to be the struggle. Transporting the peoples. So once this guy makes it to wherever he needs to go, I want to really fix up, like, this situation. Way too many people waiting on line 1 up in here. So we're going to get, like, that many more and throw these guys all on line 1. And then we're going to fix that, because I'm tired of that. No more lines. No more lines. This is the Phoenix bus. The Phoenix bus. And let's take in a close-in look at Phoenix. Someone posted on Transport Fever Nation, what do you like better about Transport Fever over Train Fever? And let's throw a flip question on that. What do you miss from Train Fever, if anything, that's not in Transport Fever? I'm continuing that discussion here. You guys post below. What do you think? One of the things I love is not invisible vehicles and such. Passengers actually travel, and you can click on them inside... the vehicles that they travel in, even the passenger wagons and all that stuff. I thought that's all pretty cool. Still love these little junkers in here. Yes, that's right. There's even a passenger inside here that you could maybe finagle away in there and click on at some point if there was a passenger. But, oh no, there is a passenger. Nice. My worry now is I'm at 2.57 million. We've got to pay attention. Are we on the up and up? I think all these DC-3s are going to start really killing my money. Not good. Not good. Set line to LA bus line. Thank you. Nope. San Diego bus line. Boom. Right? Right. Good deal, because that's what these guys are waiting on. SD bus line. Overkill on it, but everything should be okay. 2 million, we are losing money really fast, and it's got to be due to... Look at this air travel. Come on, man. There you go. There it is. Come on now. No, no, no. These are all failures in my eyes. Phoenix, and then these guys in Las Vegas. However, we're doing good in the, what is it? San Diego to Phoenix is doing well. And then we had a hidden line here. Look at this. LV to S. Okay. LV to San Diego. Because I had some that were like, right? Don't I have like a San Diego to Las Vegas? Kind of like the flipperoo kind of deal? I don't know. Anyway, most things here are named. This guy's doing okay. This guy's doing okay. This guy is. These guys are doing terrible. So let's find out in Vegas, is anybody waiting yet? I mean, this is, okay, there we go. Look at that. LV to SD, we've got 29 people waiting. LA to L, what are you? What are you? What kind of plane are you? LA to LV, no, we needed the other plane back. Got an idea, buy aircraft, you. Set line, LV to SD, yes. He's very quickly gonna pick up those 15 people. Because this guy's not going to do anything, because he's LA to LV. And the money's back up again. Whoo! I thought we were just dying, but these guys went from just losing tons of money to 150K. Okay, okay. If we can get these DCs to really start picking people up, we might be okay. We might make it out of this alive. Okay, what do you got? 8 of 8? And you have 12 people. What is this line for? Ooh. Another hidden line. Line 4. And there's a lot of people waiting for it. So what do you got here? Line number 4, who doesn't have a... What? Hold on. Buy aircraft. Buy a DC-3. You're going on line 4. You are my Santa Barbara to Phoenix airport. Very nice. Okay, this is the episode of organization of plane lines. That's right. This is airport, not airport madness. Feels like it though, right? With all the air traffic control and such. I'm feeling kind of sad. I'm going to be traveling for work for about a week or two. I have maybe a handful of videos kind of that I'll be releasing while I'm away. I will be available in the comments. I will be active on the Facebook page. But I won't be able to record anything this week. Hopefully in the weekend when I'm back for a short amount of time, I might get some late night recording in after some hanging out with the fams. So we shall see. But it's 1932, April. We've just got to transport people and pay off a penalty. So it's basically play and pray. Truly, truly playing and praying. But I think the money's going to be coming in good now. I'm not going to skip to the future just yet. I want to see how things are going. See, do one more pass by on everything here. Here's the thought. What about a second train on this line? I think you would overcatch up, and then I'm not actually producing enough machines to really deal with that. So I don't know. Maybe overkill on there, but I'm happy. The extra buses seem to be helping out quite a bit by getting people to my airport. I'm going to need maybe a few more. I'm not liking that. Look at that, 17 people. Plus, we got to really start checking, do I have bus stops covering everything? It looks like we're doing good on that. Yeah, we're doing really good on all that stuff. Because look at this line. Everyone's still loving these Monty tours. Like, wow. Really loving it. So much that I've got to, let's throw a bunch more on there. Monty tours. People loving the canyon, man. Maybe I've got some video footage of my USA Train Fever content going on in the Grand Canyon tours. Maybe we play it on the bus. Oh! Whoa, that was close. He should be flying out way sooner than that. He actually almost like wheel touched that guy. Oh my friend, you better watch yourself. I unfortunately am not at a point to where I can upgrade the station any larger here. I don't even think, I can't remember the year. 1950, 1960, something like that, where you can actually finally get the larger airports and all that. But we're hopefully not playing any way past 1943. That's what I think our medal is for, right? 1943, finished by then, and we want to have at least 20 planes by the end of the mission. By the end of the mission. So there's really no rush to add those planes now. I should have just thrown those planes on right at the very end. So what that could actually help with, like these guys, I might send some of these little guys to the depot and then spend a bunch of money at the end. Because right now they're just kind of getting in the way. They're definitely getting in the way here. I'm really hoping all these guys are going to start making more money, though. This guy's killing me on the LA to LV line. Actually, this guy, you can go ahead and... He needs to go to depot. Watch, I say that. There's probably a ton of people here waiting for him. LA LV. One person waiting. No, he can turn around. No, he can't turn around and go to depot. But anyway, I'm sending him home. He's losing me way too much money. And they're just getting in each other's way. This guy can go for a loop anyway, because he needs to let them haul up and wait for more. So, like I said, now it's at a point where it's not, hey, 420, it's not that crazy interesting. It's more of just, yeah, like I said again, pray and play. No, play and pray. Oh, there we go. Anyway, some of these airports are doing really well. Some of them are hurting pretty bad. This guy... I'm wondering where I should spend my money. Or maybe what these guys could do is just upgrade. Because look at that. There's so many people waiting here. But I want the big planes in here. I want the big planes going. But you know what? I'm going to be doing fine on the DC-3s. We're fine. I'm just paranoid. I'm just not making enough money. That's the problem. Is we're definitely on the decline now, and we used to be making so much money. So much money. That we've just got to find other ways to really skyrocket that. Like all this crude. The crude mistake. Not so much of a mistake now, is it? When we got all this going. Big money, big money. Machines are still doing good. Wow, that's a lot of people over here. What are they all waiting for? Las Vegas to San Diego. People like that line. Very nice. Alright, as long as we start seeing these planes filling up more and more like they are. I think I just kind of jumped the gun on the freak out. And I'm going to let this play out. And I'll bring you guys back in the future. Hold on tight. 19, let's pick a spot. Let's find somewhere cool. Let's go to LA, man. LA's cool, right? That's where all the cool kids hang out. The coast of LA, not as much beachfront as I would hope. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see next time. Let's jump into the future and finish this one out now, shall we? Hold on, 1933, prepare to warp. Engage. Well, I'm bringing you back. It is only December of 1933. It's been about 30 seconds, but I own at least 20 planes somehow. I accidentally bought that plane because what I'm hoping to do is add it to San Diego, Santa Barbara, because that guy's actually doing really well. So let's do some counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I trust your math now, Transport Fever. I don't trust my own. We were actually on the incline of money. We were at about 6 million, so I'm pretty confident now we are... Oh, we're on the final trail. We've just got to finish before 1943, and we will get another mission with all the medals in the books. Yes, we're doing pretty good on that. So we're going full speed. This time, instead of an LA future, we warped about like 3 months. That wasn't really anything crazy. We are going to warp into the future from San Diego because the planes are going up quickly. The money's going up in an all right amount. But it will be going up really fast. I just bought those new planes, so bear with me. Rawr. Let's hold on. All right, welcome back to the future. We are not in San Diego anymore. No, Dorothy. It is not happening that way, but we do have a double train. That's right, the Ruby Express is no longer just a diamond in the rough. No, 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 you are not all alone, my friend. You have a full other train. It cost all the money I had. However, this thing's dropping off. Watch. Wait for it. Finances. Silly amounts of big money when it does drop off. So, we got another one going. It's definitely going to help haul all this iron ore and coal out of the way. My concern, like I mentioned, was that I did a little overkill here. And this might not be actually needed supply. It was just like building up supply over time. However, I'm hoping... just by picking up what's here and dropping it off. Hey, it's there. So if I drop that off, that's money. So I'm going to take this money however I can take it. But now we've got two full trains, and I'm going to sit here and let you guys watch the cars go by and see the amount of money that goes on. And as a kid, I always enjoyed going by the airport. I was in from upstate New York, like Captain Archer. Never gives a real answer. Even the ID just says from upstate New York. So I'm going to start going with that. That's just where I'm from. Whoa, another close pass over there. But the train's coming in. But as I was saying, when I was a kid, I used to go to the airports all the time, hung out, watched the planes come in, and it was right by a train freight station as well. I was one of those kids. I played some throwback Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 last night or something, whatever, where the intro movie shows the kid like throwing the penny down on the rail and then the rail like flattens it. I don't know if you guys did that as a kid. Totally did it. Come after me. I know. Bad child. It's like those machines, but now they turned it into like an actual press. Hey, funny thing, one of those coins that I have where you put a penny in, and then, which is 1 cent, and then you put in 50 cents to turn the penny into like a logo of something, and it crushes the penny. So yes, you have to pay more money to destroy less money. But the one I have is actually for the Hoover Dam. That's kind of funny. I did a little gift shop right before you go over across a little bridge on the Hoover Dam. Actually, I went over the Hoover Dam at the time. And got a crushed penny. Funny how it all comes around in transport fever 500,000 years later. And moving right along. Like I said, things are going to go pretty well now that we have two trains on the way in at almost all times. What I'm thinking to make this a little bit more efficient, because it shouldn't be that expensive, is let's double this track out. Yeah, it's not much money. Chump change. I want to move this track out a little bit more to give it a little bit more efficiency here. So we're going to put that guy there. I'm going to pause the game real quick. Just a real quick pause. Because we've got to fix this. Not a safe thing to try to fix while we're not paused here. So let's get that going. That's good. Very good, my friend. Let me turn off the heater. My bad, but it is freezing in here. But I know that that's probably loud and annoying, so I apologize for that for a few minutes. I know I had that off for the first section of video. Oh, no, come on now. What if I go this way? Yeah, you like that direction, don't you? Throw a little signal in here. We'll put a modern signal. Moving up in the times here. And then full speed ahead. Delete key. Verify that I actually connected that properly. Railroad. Should we see the split? Yes, we do. The lines are good and gravy. 6.23, 6.33. We've got 7 more years to go. Let's look at everything and find out who is killing us with money. And if you're killing us with money like this, like right here, what's your problem? Probably just not worth it, huh? Probably just not worth it. So what we're going to do is we're going to sell everything on Santa Barbara to Phoenix. Just sell it all. And what I'm thinking, though, is putting one. Because it did look like... Yeah. What we need to do is put them on a bigger plane that's worth it. Those little junkers aren't worth it anymore. Oh, no. Is it to... Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Santa Barbara to Phoenix. Set line. There you go. Now we got a plane. Who else is hurting? Let's look. It's probably all airfare. Okay. Where we were hurting were the people who still had some of these junkers. These guys aren't doing very well either. That's brand new line, but look, he should be, as long as he's full, from here to there. There he is. Ah, 4 of 8. And he's going to Phoenix. As long as he's full most of the time, we should get back in the profits here. Anyway. Full speeds are still ahead. Like I said, every time one of these trains drops off, we make like about 3 million. So this shouldn't take very long, especially when I've got these trains going full speed. Look at them go. Ooh, that DC just misses that building. Let's see how far the DC can go. How many trips can the DC go before we win the game? I was hoping for a tongue twister there, but that didn't really get very twisty, did it? Little bugs flying around everywhere, though. Let's just shut off everything now. As far as UI stuff, no numbers, no... Oh, that is close. We almost wingtip right there. Coming around the corner, though, that's a pretty nice spot. And this is the stretched out finish to mission number 5. But we're going to knock it out. We're going to get all these medals. And do it right. Get it done, do it right. As soon as I was like, hey, we're making good money, it went ku-do-do-dung. It dropped down. Dropped down hard. Let's see, what do we got? 6 people waiting. Yeah, 7 people waiting. Come on, come on, come on. Let's hit 8. Yes. That's all I want. That's all I want. Full loads. Now, San Diego to Phoenix. Holding strong, too. So I think we're doing fine now. And they can't take my medal away, so I can delete planes now. That's what I was thinking. I earned the medal, now I can delete the medal. 4 million, come on now, 4 million. I think he's gonna make it. I think he's gonna make it. Where'd he go? Check him out, he's back in the air. Leaving Phoenix on the way back. Remember, we're gonna see how many trips can this guy go. I don't think he'll make it back to Phoenix. No, I think he'll make it back to Phoenix. That's probably about it. Depends where those trains are. Oh, one going up, one going down. Oh, I'm very curious if there's any goods there. See, I know, anytime I turn off my UI, I finally need it. So let's escape. Let's see. Does he still have anything? Look at that, 483 iron ore. That is connected well. Something's not connected. Try to ship more. It's just giving me a warning. Good. 12 million in the bank. Yeah, look at that. 91 on steel trucking. 91 by road vehicles. Steel trucking. We need some bigger trucks. So adding that second train really beefed up the industry here. And got these towns just on a roll. So everything's good now. So let's recap. Let's talk about what we could have done better. I think we would have finished way faster if I would have gone trains with the crude oil, which when I did my playthrough, I did trains here, trucks here. I think if you go heavy transport fever here and go train, trucks all up in the top area by the Hoover Dam, trucks all down here with the steel and all that. But let me know. Remember, like I said on the Facebook page, the Monte Rico Gaming Elite Community, as it is now called. We have had a few people posting some cool like layouts and stuff like that. Haven't seen too much stuff on missions, a lot of free play stuff. which is definitely cool. That's what I like doing too. I'll be back in my free play as well, and I'm also getting very close to picking
the debts have been a custom map. People are going
there we have it.
Mad. Boom, boom. With our attractive offers. Boom, boom, boom. Honk, 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 honk. Skies.
Lords of the Skies, mission complete. The debts have been settled, and the people are going aviation mad. Especially with our attractive offers. We are the Lords of the Skies. I do like that. 78K in the bank. They basically stole all of our money. But I think we have an infrastructure to take over the U.S. We will be the best airline ever. We shall see how things go. Now, do remember, you can always continue playing on these campaign maps and then free play it your own way. You could play this all the way into the future, get modern trains, play on the California coast. Just don't forget about that. And also, make sure you comment. Let me know what is up with you guys, everybody. Hope to see you soon. Like I said, I'm going to be out for about a week or so. Maybe about a week and a half, but I'll have some trickled in videos. Be around in the comments, and we'll be back in heavy towards the end of January. I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching another Transport Fever episode. This was the end of mission number 5. Stay tuned for more America Campaign. Peace.